Hurricane Michael is just hours away from slamming into the Florida Panhandle, now a Category 3 that's stronger than Florence. We have new information on what to expect and when. The big question is whether or not Florida is ready. There are lots of eyes on Tallahassee Mayor Andrew Gillum right now. He wants to be governor, and Hurricane Michael may stand in his way. Plus, Nikki Haley's departure. Surprise or not, the president said he knew months ago, yet her staff, Bolton, Pompeo, all reportedly caught off guard. Why did the UN ambassador announce her exit just weeks before the midterms? We'll dig deeper for you. And if you're watching this show, you know Chicago has a unique gun violence problem. Is stop and frisk the solution? The president is pushing for it. Is it what he says, or is it a recipe for a new problem? It's that time again, my friends. Let's get after it. All right, we know this as a matter of fact. Hurricane Michael is barreling toward the Gulf Coast. It's not weakening. It's gotten stronger. Florida candidates are putting a pause on politics with only 4 weeks until Election Day, but they have a job to do, and it literally could be life or death. On Monday, President Trump, he didn't take a break. He called out one of the candidates, Democratic nominee for Governor Andrew Gillum, for being corrupt and a ticket to making Florida Venezuela. Gillum is also mayor of Florida's capital, Tallahassee. So what does he have to say about this slight in the midst of a Category 3 hurricane, 120-mile-an-hour winds headed his way? Andrew Gillum, thank you for joining us. Let's deal with what matters here first. How are you doing in terms of preparation?
Well, we feel very good about our government's preparation. We feel like we're ready for this storm. Chris, as you know, we're unfortunately, over the last 3.5 years, well practiced this being our third storm that we've had to encounter. What we want to make sure of at this stage is that our residents are making the proper preparations to deal with what will be a life-threatening event. This will be the strongest storm to hit our area in over a century. And we want to make sure that people are taking it serious and making the appropriate preparations.
Right. Now, here's the problem. One, people get complacent with time. You haven't been hit this way in a while. So the memory gets short. People think that it was easier than it actually was in some cases. Second, you've got a lot of poverty in and around this area that's going to be vulnerable. There are rural places outside of places like Tallahassee. People are remote, hard to reach. How do you deal with those challenges?
Yeah, well, we have had to be a welcoming place to other communities in times of natural disaster, and this time is no different. We have opened up 5 shelters so far all around our community with, I believe, a 6th that may be online as early as tomorrow morning. We know that we are already receiving guests from some of the lower-lying areas along the coast, given the storm surge that they're going to be facing. So we're welcoming those folks here, and we're trying to make it as comfortable a stay as possible. But really what's at stake here is the life and the safety and the security of people. And if they're in those low-lying areas or here in my own community, if you're in a modular unit or a mobile home, we want you to get out of harm's way and go to one of our shelters where we can at least assure to your safety. Listen, we can put houses back together, but we cannot replace a life. And so we're hoping people will take advantage of the sheltering opportunities that are available to them.
Amen. Now, one exigency of a political nature is registration. Registration window is about to close. The storm could very well complicate efforts to get people registered to vote. People in your party are calling for a delay where they can reopen the window after the storm. Your position?
Well, I mean, I think we want to do everything we can to assure that people get the opportunity to get registered to vote. I think you probably saw some of the spikes that have been reported on the final day of voter registration that occurred just in the last 24 hours. We know that people make a rush toward the end. And I would plead with the governor and on those in charge of this process to extend the opportunity for as many people to get involved and get registered in the process as possible. If you're worried about your life and safety, you're probably not thinking about voter registration at this moment. And so a little bit of grace for those folks, I think, is in order.
Now, 2016, you guys in Tallahassee, and you specifically, got blame put on you for not accepting the governor's offer of help. You say you have an answer to that, that that's a false charge. What's the reality?
Well, it is a false charge. Unfortunately, that was a situation where we had a storm get politicized. And I think that's the last thing that you want in a storm event where people are trying to keep themselves and their families safe. That was the first storm to hit our community in over 30 years. We woke up the next day to recognize that over 90% of our public infrastructure had been devastated, our entire sewer system knocked out. And what we came out and said is that we would work as diligently as we could to get our community up and going. 72 hours later, over 90% of the people in my community had their power restored. And then we obviously worked as a community over the remaining days to get people back connected. I think what President Trump did last night by attacking me, attacking my city, I don't think we've ever seen a sitting president go after a sitting mayor in a community that is preparing itself for a near Category 4 hurricane to attack it. Listen, we don't need partisanship. We need a president. We need a partner. We need someone who is going to come to our aid when we need it, not throw cheap political shots.
Well, Mr. Mayor, for those who didn't hear it, here it is.
If you look at Ron DeSantis, he's doing fantastically well. I backed him from the beginning. He's great. He's doing a fantastic job. He'll be a great governor. His opponent runs a place that has a lot of problems, and I know it very well, but it's got a lot of problems, tremendous corruption, tremendous crime. This is not what you want to run Florida. His opponent is, I think, a horrible choice.
So is this a reflection of just our new normal? Nothing is sacred. Nothing is above politics. Well, nothing is apolitical. It's all go all the time.
Well, I find it unfortunate. I find it most unfortunate, obviously, because of the timing, and secondly, because of the fact that it's not true. I preside over a city that is experiencing right now a 5-year low in our crime rate. The hardworking men and women who you may be able to see behind me, they deserve better from their commander-in-chief. They don't deserve to be reduced to partisan politics. They're working as hard as they can to keep the life and safety of the people who they have charge over protected in what will be a pretty major storm. The president should have taken that opportunity to encourage people to get out of harm's way, to prepare themselves for the storm, and then to offer his unmitigated support, not just to me, but to my state, in the aftermath of this disaster to help us get back up and going as quickly as possible.
Well, look,
but regardless of that, I know that we're ready, we're prepared, and we're going to do what it takes to make sure that our community gets up and going.
Well, look, let's hope everything there, that everything's a little bit exaggerated. Let's hope. Let's hope it's better. As I was saying to Anderson before the show started, it's the only time a journalist wants to be wrong. I hope these estimates are wrong. I hope I don't have to be down there with you face-to-face 36 hours from now, because we're dealing with such a terrible aftermath, and that we see President Trump, taking jump shots with paper towels to people who are desperate in our own state of Florida. A lot of your people and citizens in your state watch the show. What is your message to them right now? Hopefully they're going to have power up and through when the storm comes tomorrow afternoon, but the window is closing. What do you want them to know?
Well, first off, if you're one of our neighbors who is along the coastline, the storm surge that is expected there is life-threatening. It is deadly. If you have not gotten out yet, do not assume that you can ride this storm out. Get to higher ground. Come to your capital city here in the city of Tallahassee. We will do our very best to accommodate you here. For my residents here in the Tallahassee-Leon County area, know that we're ready for this storm. Your government is ready, and what you need to ensure is that you're ready in your own homes and your own neighborhood. We will be able to repair and get back up and going in our communities. What's most important at this time is that you keep yourselves and your family safe during this storm event, which will begin in earnest in just a few hours here.
All right, Mr. Mayor, as we say with all local leaders, when this kind of event is headed their way, use us as a resource. If you have information that needs to get out, if you want to coordinate getting people the help they need in the aftermath, we're here for you. That's why we have the job.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you
well.
For that. Really appreciate it, Chris, and Godspeed.
All right. Be safe. I hope that it is better than expected. Mayor Andrew Gillum, good luck to you.